Good morning. We saw yesterday that there are certain activities that are advisable to not engage in during the 3 weeks, even though they're strictly speaking not prohibited, but indeed they should be avoided even before the 9 days and even before Shavuot Shechalba, for example, taking tiulim, engaging in dangerous activities. And we also saw there's a second category that ideally should be avoided even during the 3 weeks before the 9 days and Shavuot Shechalba, as we saw in the stipler that he avoided things that brought him simcha. For example, he would be strict about not receiving his newly printed books during this time period because it would be masamech, it would make him happy, and that should be avoided also. The Piskei Tshuva says that how does that apply on Shabbos during the 3 weeks? So he says this concept of decreasing simcha applies to things that are divrei reshus, things that we're not required to do, things that are voluntarily, that we're taking upon ourselves, activities, for example, that we don't need to engage in, going on a jeeping trip and doing things that we may think are a lot of fun, but certainly not required. Those are the things that ideally should be avoided during this time period. However, when it comes to our avoda to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, for example, learning Torah, davening, that should all be besimcha rabba. That should all be with excitement and happiness, because this is indeed a special time to come close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And he says, especially during the Shabbos of Bein HaMetzarim, between Shivas Arba Tammuz and Tisha B'Av. So we see here that simcha should not be avoided when it comes to davening and learning, and especially on Shabbos. And he adds on that it's not only Bein Avdam L'Makom, and our relationship with the Kaddish Baruch Hu, but indeed we should work on having strong, close relationships and kinship to other Jews, because we have to always recall that the destruction of the Second Temple was because of sinas chinam, baseless hatred to other Jews. This is a time that we indeed should show baseless love to other Jews. So those are both important points. Just a quote from a couple of Sfarim of the Achronim that build out this concept when it comes to Shabbos, the importance of having simcha and having that close connection to HaKadosh Baruch Hu during this time of year that we may otherwise feel dejected. The Sefer Avodas Yisrael says that we should be mechazik ourselves, we should be metahar, purify our hearts to worship God, both in our learning and also in our davening, and it should be besimcha, and we should be singing songs, especially on Shabbos, shiras v'tishbachos, singing and praising of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, v'sameach lev ha-melech, and we should be mesameach keviyachol HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and the simcha should be focused on bringing geula b'mehira v'yameinu. The Toldos Adam, another sefer, says that something unbelievable, says that this 21 days of Bein HaMetzarim, in other words, the 21 days between Shivas Arba Tammuz and Tisha B'Av, reflects the 21 days between Rosh Hashanah and Shmini Atzeres. That's the time that we typically think of as tshuva and building our souls. The 21 days that we have now effectively will give us a turbo boost. He doesn't say this exactly, but it gives us a turbo boost that if we can get closer to Kadosh Baruch Hu and engage in proper tshuva, that is going to help us tremendously comes the time of Rosh Hashanah, because we've already been mitakin everything. We've already gone through our tshuva process, and he goes as far as to say that we don't even have to be scared from the Yom HaDin, from Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, if we do a good job at this time of year. And then he adds on, as it relates to Shabbos, Ubi Yoser Yachol HaTikon Lios B'Shabbatos, especially this tikkun and the improvement of our spiritual status can especially happen on the Shabbos during our 3 week period now. Kihem Gedolim Yoser Mikol Shabbatos Hashanah, because they are greater in this way than any other Shabbos of the entire year. Have a nice day.